When I first finished my playthrough of A Bird Story, I was too overcome with emotion to really be able to say anything coherent, so I figured it would probably be best to wait a bit and make a separate video. This is of course going to be full of spoilers, so if you are worried about that, then do not watch. So, A Bird Story is, at its core, a very simple story. It's, well, about a boy and a bird. But within its roughly 1 hour running time, it manages to touch on a lot of different things. So it starts out basically being about a lonely boy who likes to daydream, and how he meets this bird, and saves it, nurses it back to health, and in doing so finds a new friend. They both do. At first, it's about this period of bonding. You know, first the bird is scared of him, doesn't really trust him, doesn't trust the boy, but then they start to build that trust and they start to like each other. And then it's about this, well, basically just about this friend. You know, they like to eat together and play together. He likes to throw paper airplanes at it, which it catches and only sometimes gives back. You know, it's really lovely. It's about bonding with this strange little creature. And then later, it becomes a story about letting go. Because as much as they like each other, the boy starts to realize that the bird has its own home. It needs to go back to its home. It has its own family. You know, it doesn't belong with him. As much as they like each other's company, it just really does not belong with him. And you have to let a friend go. So it's about, in a way, love and loss. So, yeah, it managed to touch on a lot of things through this very simple story. And little bits of interaction that it allows you just felt so right, because it's a very simple game, there's not much interaction. For the most part, you just press a couple buttons and move around a bit, but most of it's not really interactive. But there are some moments that are, and they just felt perfect. Like, when you get to play in the puddles and jump around in them, that just felt so good, you know, just to be a kid and play in puddles. That's awesome. And then when you get to actually throw the paper airplane at the bird. And then, of course, finally, when you had to release the bird. Let it go. It just felt so right that you had to actually press those buttons, you know, it's not just something that you watched. It still would have been powerful, even if it was just something that you watched, but I think it made it extra powerful that you actually had to do it yourself. You know, you have to let it go. And I thought that was wonderful. And that it manages to do all these things without having any dialogue at all is really amazing. And I think it's a testament to the creator's skill in telling a story through the visuals, the sounds, and especially the music, because the soundtrack is just... I mean, the soundtrack almost is the dialogue. It's impeccable, beautiful, incredibly emotive music that just fits so perfectly. So it's a very simple story, and it's a very simple game. But somehow it still manages to be so relatable. And it manages to tell a coherent story without any dialogue. And it manages to be about love and life and friends and letting go. It really is beautiful.